We're going to focus on relational databases because this model is what the databases that are widely used, Oracle, for example. So the databases that are widely used in real world, they actually use this relational model. So that's one reason we're going to focus on it. It's also been around and investigated heavily and so on. So what is a relational database? What's the data model here? Well, a relational database consists of what is called relations. Another name for relation is a table. Remember, a table is basically sort of like rows and columns. It's a matrix kind of a structure. So a relation is nothing but sort of a table that has a bunch of columns and bunch of rows. So what columns we have, what kind of data items you're going to have in the various columns in the database or in a relation, that's defined by a schema that we have for that relation. The schema basically says what each column is and what is the nature of the data. Is it a name? It's an address? It's a social security number? Whatever it is. The columns defined by what we call attributes. So the values that we store in the various columns actually are attribute values. So think about a schema defines what these various columns of the table are or the various attributes are, and value for a given attribute is the attribute value. We talked about columns or attributes, but of course, then we have rows in a table. So a given row is going to contain a value for each of the attributes as defined by the schema that we're talking about. So each column, row, so cell of a matrix or a table basically has a value. So these rows are called tuples. So tuples basically, as I said, are values, attribute values that make up that row of the table. And what these values are, again, is defined by the schema that we have. It's a table, and their attribute values and the rows are called tuples and things like that. You know, some of those attribute values are kind of special. They're called keys. The various types of keys, primary and foreign and stuff like that. But keys are basically values that uniquely define a given tuple or a row. So if a database stores information about each employee, there's going to be a tuple for each employee. Information about that employee is going to be stored in the table or the relation. A given employee's information will define one tuple. And if you identify employees by, let's say, their social security number, then that's going to be the key value in that tuple. And it's uniquely identifies that tuple because social security numbers are different for different users.